Welcome to ToddFun.com, where I'm going to talk real quick about how to service an 8-track tape. Now, one of the issues is as these get older, there's between where the track change is, there's some glue, which glues the loop together. And that glue will eventually fail and unspool. So you got to re-glue it and re-spool it. And sometimes these just get pulled out. So what do you do about that? Well, you want to carefully disassemble them, and there's a lot of YouTube videos out there, but ultimately they come apart differently. Some of them have different clips in different areas, and what you want to do is, in this case, you have a clip right here that has to pop off, and then a clip that's on this side that has to pop off, and both of those are accessed, I'll hold my finger on the tape here, from the back side. There's a hole here and there's a hole here. And you just reach in there and you pry carefully, and then you can get this tape to release a little bit. You just want it to release a little bit, and then flip it over so that the front of the tape is up, and then lift the top off, because this will unspool if you do it backwards. This is the drive wheel. It's a piece of plastic wheel. And what you do then is you then pull out some of the tape so that you can cut and splice. I'll talk about that in a second. But how the tape actually works is it spins the wheel this way, so it spins it clockwise as you're looking at it. And that's what the drive pinion does, the drive arbor, if you will. And that essentially is pulling tape off this side. And this side goes into the center of the reel. And so as it's spooling this, it's pulling on this center of the reel. And as it pulls on the center of the reel, it turns the whole reel, and it picks up on this side. And that pretty much maintains the tension. If you have a tension problem, that is, you see gaps inside the tape, what you can do is hold the reel and pull on this side, and it'll start to tighten it up. But that's okay. You can do that too. But either way, you gotta pull some out and judge that the tension is right. And there's other videos on that if you want more detail on that. But for the most part, it needs to look like this. Not too tight in the middle, not too loose on the outside. And then for the tape here, what I do is I take and I just cut out the section that had the splice. And now some tapes will have, most tapes will have a metal piece of tape there. It's metal because there's two contacts that are sensing. And when this track comes around, it signals the end of the track, it'll see there's a pickup, there's a sensor pickup that has like two prongs that sees that piece of conductive tape go by and then signals down to the mechanism to run a solenoid to change the reed head track, essentially track 1, 2, 3, 4. But I don't have that on mine, so I'm not worried about the metal tape. And you would have to make sure you got the correct metal tape for that. I have tried other types of metal tape, and it has failed. That is, it gets around to it, and then the drive mechanism gets stuck on it because it's too thick or too slippery. But I don't need that, so what I did is I just put some crazy glue on the back side of this cut, and then made sure that I put this cut on the back side so that it goes essentially like this. You don't want to do it like this, because then this will get picked up and peeled off. You want to be like this because it's going this way. And you want that drive wheel to, if this is the drive wheel, you want it to be spinning like this. And you want it to come off of the one tape and onto the other tape and not catch anything. And I just, about a half inch of crazy glue, maybe a little more. I use the crazy glue that's more of a gel. And I spread it on with a Q-tip. And then I make sure it's perfectly lined up. And then I touch it together. And yeah, you got to be careful. But you might want to do that before you ruin the tape, if you know that you have old tapes, because they'll eventually fail anyway. Or you have some spooled out, and that's the situation you might be in right now as well. Likewise, not only can you buy that metal tape for the automatic track switching, you can buy this foam that goes in here. I've seen people use some foam from doors and stuff as well, but you can buy this online still. And that just drops in and gives it something for the reed head to push against on the tape. Then you got this slack problem. So what you do for that is that because it comes out of the center and it comes over top of this edge around this spool point here and around this spool and back in. Just make sure it's lined up like that, and then just start pulling. And because you're not doing anything but pulling on this side, this circle is bigger on the outside than the inside. So just because of that, it's going to, I sometimes put my finger here just to keep it from lifting up and falling off, but it's going to be pulling this tape back in faster than you're pulling it out. There it goes. And that's what will pick up the slack. And my finger here is just keeping the tape from lifting up and flipping off. Essentially adding a little bit of a tension, if you will. Just a light tension. And you'll notice this loop is getting smaller because of that mechanics of the larger spool on the outside and smaller spool on the inside. It is a little bit loose here, so I can tighten it up. And I took out that slack, and then I can continue. I got some crinkles in it because it did get eaten a couple times, and I've had to re-spool it a few times. And as you notice, it's just getting smaller and smaller. I'll tighten that up a little bit again. Gets a little boring at this point, but tighten up. Tighten up. And when you get to the end here, you can just spool it up if you want. Just run it with your finger if you want. Get that last little bit on there. And there, now you want to be on the inside of this one here, though. There's a little plastic prong right here. I want to be on the inside of that plastic. I want to be inside of that plastic right there, so it doesn't get pinched. There we go. And that's what it should look like. And now it's just a matter of, well, this one has like a little plastic ring. If I can pick it up, it's like a little plastic ring that seems to just drop in there. Keeps this tape, I guess, coming off the reel correctly. And then you just line this back up. Make sure you're not pinching any of your tape. And you just press down and it'll snap. There you go. And there, I have re-glued and re-spooled and re-tensioned my 8-track. Thanks for that quick one.